So I was once telling the Greenville News that what we need to do is internalize the negative externalities. And the reporter stopped me and said, "What's that, Bob?" I said, "Internalize the negative externalities." He said, "Can't write that in this paper, man. We write at the seventh grade level." And so I said, "Okay, reveal the hidden costs." He said, "Yep, I can put that in here." And so what I realized, I need to come up with some way to explain it. So when I'd go to Boys State, what I decided to do was take volunteers out of the audience. It's always easy to get volunteers at Boys State. So they come up to the stage, and so I get one of them to make electricity. And what I tell them to do is, I need you to make electricity. Every time energy is going to get low in here, I'm going to tell you, now listen, what we need you to do is make some power. And I'd say, now, just make some power when we need it. And so then the other one, I'd say, now you, when we need power, this is how you can do it. You're just going to make it like this. And so it looks like a windmill, right? And so I get the kids in to walk around making power while I'm talking. And so every once in a while I call them and say, "Wait a minute, energy's low. The energy levels get low in here. Make some power." So the one goes like this, and the other starts blowing bubbles. Well, when they blow the bubbles, the boys, of course, on cue, start playing with the bubbles, right? And so now we've got everybody being touched by the bubbles. Well, I tell them, "I'm sorry to tell you that the bubbles were actually lung disease. And the way he was making power was putting out soot and other things that were causing lung disease. So now all of you that got touched with the bubble, you got lung disease." And I put them in four groups. I say that, okay, this is the Medicare group. This is the Medicaid group. This is Blue Cross Blue Shield, the company that covers me and my family. And this is the people who are uninsured. And then I say to the people in the audience, "Now, take out your wallets, because we're now going to pay for all these people's lung disease." And earlier I told them, "Now, the guy that's making power this way and not emitting anything, his power looks more expensive. This guy that was blowing the bubbles looked cheaper. Until now, that all these people are up here on stage with lung disease, and we're all going to pay for it. And so now, we put all those costs on this guy's power that was making it with the bubbles." And then, of course, the boys start getting in. They say, "Yeah, you mean it could actually turn out to be cheaper, that this one that wasn't emitting anything is actually cheaper in the long run?" But then we have a discussion about how, if all the costs are in, on all the fuel, so that you can see what, for example, wind or solar, maybe even nuclear, what it looks like, that power source, what the cost of it looks like, compared to the fully accountable fossil fuels. And of course, the neat thing is the boys are quick to point out that, yeah, and this is gonna run out. Because I ask them, "What's the difference between these?" And they say, "Well, this one's gonna run out. Eventually, this boy's gonna run out of soap suds. This one's going to keep on going because it's inexhaustible, it's renewable, it's solar, it's wind, it's something like that." But they look, the point of the whole illustration is to internalize the negative externalities. And so I tell them, now, when you go to college, first day of Econ 101, you're going to be able to say, "Professor, what we need to do is internalize the negative externalities." And tell them, you get an A on the first day in Econ 101.